Hey, folks, it's me, Bugsy. I hope you like the fact that I'm still kind of keeping the chaos bent arc still going. It's just like, guys, I got freaking Starlink with on the Switch, Star Fox, and I'm like, oh my god, I know this ain't Star Fox, but let me trick my brain a little bit. Let me trick my brain. I haven't played Super Mario Party yet. I'm going to. But yeah. So today I'm really, really, truly sorry, guys. I was playing Fist of the North Star mostly like half of the day when I got up, and I just couldn't stop. I love Fist of the North Star so fucking much. You guys know. You guys know I can do the what? And you're already dead. You think I'd get tired of doing the same move over and over again, but I'm not. I just love it. And it's just I didn't like the one character in the game. I don't know if it was in the manga or they just added him. I didn't like G-Ray at first, but he's pretty cool. I'm still playing it. I think I'm on like what am I on? I'm on chapter 6 now. It's pretty good. Again, this is what I wanted in a Fist of the North Star game. Not that whole Dynasty Warriors thing they tried to do. I mean, that was okay. That was fine. But I feel like, Yakuza's kind of game type fits in the Fist of the North Star pretty well. Which makes me think, guys, Berserk. Berserk. Like, seriously, guys, would you want to see Berserk in that style? Because I kind of want to now. Anyways, folks. Also, saw some videos on, on this YouTube channel called Fox saying that the cinematic universe is overrated. Just a bunch of things where they're going like, it's over. I mean, he makes a bunch of half excuses about why the Marvel Cinematic Universe is what it is. I'm like, when you really think about it, the Cinematic Universe is everything that the comics are. It's a living, breathing universe that they made in the movies. Everything has an effect and everything has a counteraction. Just like it does in the comic books. But this dude, like, literally just lays down, like, half fucking truths and just saying, yo, all these crossovers in the comics are more corporate than some shows from the 70s. Like, oh, it was just maddening, guys. I'll leave you a link in the description down below, and you tell me what you think. Come back to this video and type in the comments to tell me what you think. Because honestly, I feel like this person, I feel like if it's either a group of people or just one person, you're just hating on something just because it's popular. And you know people are going to get mad at you and all this other shit. He's like, if Aquaman was in the Avengers, would anybody care? Yes, everybody would care, you fucking... Sorry, guys. Trying to cut back so much on the rage. Trying to cut back. But it's like, yes, people would care. People would know. You're like, oh, my, well, you know, they don't have any rules. Yes, they do. DC has rules. Why characters from Marvel don't come into their world? And Marvel has the same kind of rules, too. You would know this if you're, instead of just glancing at the Marvel stuff and saying that the universe is blah, 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 because it just discredits what Jack Kirby fucking Steve Ditko and Stan Lee did, and it just irks the fuck out of me. When I heard a little bit of it, I was like, it's like, ugh, motherfucker, why? You just hating on it because everybody likes it, and you're just like, there must be something wrong. I must pick at every little thing in Marvel. See, the thing is, Marvel is okay when it comes to books. There's certain books that are good, certain books that are bad right now. But DC is like hitting it. And that's the thing that really gets on my nerves. Like, DC is good when it comes to like comics right now. Marvel isn't so good when it comes to comics right now. But the movies are like hitting it out of the park. That's the eternal paradox that I freaking keep thinking about. But you know, whatever. It's just a person just hating on it because it's just a person probably having different ideas and stuff and me just having a disagreement. But I feel like he's just hating on it because everybody's loving it, you know? People like that always do that just to get more views because, you know, they know that they're going to get backlash. They know that they're going to get a lot of views because if everybody views their videos out of hatred, they're going to get a lot of views for it. Probably even a lot of retention time, too. Depending if the person's that angry enough to sit through it. But, you know, it's just... But anyways, in more pressing and pleasanter news, I just finished watching DuckTales. The season finale, and oh my fucking god, it was so great. Like, why? And I'm talking to Hollywood, I'm talking to everybody. I'm talking about everybody who's ever done a reboot in Hollywood. What is your deal? Look at DuckTales. Look at DuckTales. Look at the reboot of DuckTales. It honors the people who watch the old... Who watched DuckTales, even a little bit of the Disney in the afternoon, because they got Don Carnage! Don motherfucking Carnage! I'm just sitting here in the void room, just like, ugh. Why is it so hard for you guys to just, you guys can make changes to a reboot, but don't forget what started your reboot. The love and nostalgia from the thing that you're making a reboot of. And the DuckTales team actually understands that. They understand that than most people who make reboots. Let's make Ben 10 a kid because that's what we do. Let's make Teen Titans Go a fucking parody, but in the same vein, it's not really a goddamn parody. It's just the writers being assholes. And let's make all the other reboots and take away everything that the people loved them in the first place. I'm not saying like copy it note for note, change a little bit when you need to, but don't do what Teen Titans Go did. Don't do what all these other reboots are doing. They don't know what they're doing. They need to understand their fan base before they start. They need to understand the fan base before they start like doing shit. And that's what the DuckTales fandom did, because they're all fans of the Disney Afternoon. They understand when to make something funny and when to pound on the drama. And I love that. We find out what happened to Huey and Dewey and Louie's mom, and we actually understand, you know, it's a very actually understandable thing, and why Scrooge was the way he was at the beginning. It explains everything perfectly, but it knows when to joke. Fuck, I'm just gonna say it right now. Spoiler alert: Magic of Dispel comes into it, and she is. She's like terrorizing Scrooge, and it's just so fucking funny, and just everybody gets a chance to shine in this, and I'm so happy the way it ended, because it just leaves the door open for season 2, which it did just which did get confirmed way before season one even aired, which I gotta say is kind of a testament to DuckTales. Like, Disney knew it was a sure thing, and yet they still went with it. That's what I love. You know, Disney is sort of listening. They're trying to, at least. But, you know, it's like, people are like, oh, let me pull that video up. Let me pull, like, a little bit of that video up for you guys. About Fox. He's like, wouldn't we all be mad if, like, we all be mad if, like, we all be mad if we saw, like, an Avengers Marvel crossover? Hell yes!
Jorge Burgos fought his way up from keg washer to master brewer. Now he fights to make sure every drop has a crisp taste that's pure gold. Modelo Especial, brew with fighting spirit.
The Marvel. One dude's like, did anyone else feel like they watched nothing for 9 minutes and 30 seconds of nothing? Fox shoved the bed with this stupid video. It makes a mockery of the fans who love the MCU, and they insult their intelligence. Or, you know, lulls for research purposes. I don't know. Like, guys, I was listening to this because another person was making a response video, and I'm just like, let's go to the last part of it.
Would anybody be surprised if Disney forced a Marvel Star Wars crossover? Marvel and Disney can make the right choice. In the late 80s, the Marvel comic Damage Control toyed with the consequences of superhero life on the world at large. That made its cameo in Spider-Man Homecoming a thrilling indicator of where the MCU could go. It was a world that...
Oh my god. What you looking at, Bugs? This stupid box thing. Oh yeah, I heard about it. People like Vox. I understand you and your merry band of idiots think that, you know, y'all think that you guys think, you know, you guys really truly goddamn think that the MCU is overrated because you don't like it. You feel like you're the only one that doesn't like it, but you probably don't like it because you actually find something wrong with it. Or you have a fundamental flaw. But I feel like other people don't like it because they literally just hate it because everybody else is liking it and they just don't get it. Or they're just not big old comic book readers like me and Bugsy. So I don't think that this is actually good. Because let me tell you something. When me and Bugsy were little boys, we always wanted to see these big stories. These big comic book events as stories like movies for the big screen. And you know what? The MCU accomplishes that. It makes, like, it made Bugsy and I care about characters dying in Infinity War even though they were going to come back. Because me and Bugsy have become desensitized to the whole fact that characters die in comics, because we know it happens every fucking time. We know when characters are coming back, when is it going to happen, when is the switch going to happen, when are they going to go back, and it's just, we know this, and it's because of that we're so desensitized. We're so fucking desensitized to that one thing. It's just stuff like that. But Infinity War made us care. And that's something that... That's something me and Bugsy lost a long time ago. And I just feel like... You're just saying it's overrated because it's like... This is what the MCU could have gone. Because I was there. I heard that part. And like... Yeah, but for what it's doing, it's set, you know, from what it's doing pretty well. Box off money cannot freak, the box off money from Infinity War cannot tell you any otherwise that they're actually doing pretty well. Maybe not to you, because you throwing a, I looked at his video too, he threw in a fan theory, crossovers from the fucking 70s. Just a whole bunch of shit. And, like, what does that really equate to? That you don't like the Marvel Universe? You don't like the DC Cinematic Universe? I mean, you don't like the Marvel Cinematic Universe because you just don't like it. But instead of saying that, you have to just be like, well, it's overrated. And maybe people did ask you for it, but probably the most cynical motherfuckers that can't even have fun or even want to... smile because they think the world's a bunch of they think the world's just a giant shithole. And to that, folks, smile, 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 smile. You know that this world is a good world after all. God dang, I'm talking about that's real old. Yep. It just makes me feel a little older because you know why. Anyways, I'm just saying, I'm with Bugsy on that one. Y'all, anyway you ask for it, I'm just like, you got the power to disagree with us, but I just feel like some of you just don't like it because you guys don't like it because, you know, it's just you guys don't like it. Because you think that we don't get it, or it's just not what you think we don't get it, or we are just mindless sheep, but we actually found something we actually like. Ant-Man, Spider-Man Homecoming, Black Panther. I know a lot of people hate Black Panther, and freaking Matt and Trey did too, but we liked it. Also, not because we're black. Not just because we're black, because that's a dumb thing. We like Black Panther because, again, just shows another side of the DC universe that we wanted to see. What I really feel is great about the cinematic, the MCU, is that the fact that we finally get what we want on the big screen. The companies actually understand we want this. While the rest of you are just sitting here, I don't like it because it's popular. We're the ones buying tickets and watching it because we wanted this. While the rest of you just sit and suck. Because you feel like we don't get it. We're not smart enough to get it. And trust me, me and Bugsy are cynical motherfuckers, so we get your point. We get your point. But if you don't have the same mindset as people who are actually going to see these Marvel movies, who are Marvel fans, you don't really understand. And you're not trying to. Vox isn't sure as hell not trying to understand the other fans. It just spent like 9 minutes just bitching and moaning about the Marvel Cinematic Universe. Saying, if Aquaman showed up, we'd be like, why is he there? What's going on? Are they trying to do a Marvel versus DC movie? What's that going on there? There'd be so many fucking questions. See? there'd be people actually asking questions, making theories. See, Vox, if you want to see Vox, by saying that, you just open the floodgates. Because if Aquaman did appear in the Avengers, we'd be wondering why. That's the thing we'd be wondering. We'd be wondering why, how, where, how'd this happen? Does that mean DC and Marvel are doing like a DC versus Marvel movie? Because that has precedence in the comics too. Are we gonna have like movies where they're combined? Because that happened in the comic too. A whole bunch of questions. We'd be surprised about a Marvel Star Wars crossover, because that wouldn't make sense. They'd have to make a different continuity to where the Star Wars universe actually just comes with the Marvel universe. There's a lot of things that would have to be done to make that work. Vox? A lot of things. A lot of big things. Folks like you just want to piss people off because, you know you're going to get views either way. You solely insulted the fans just to get views. And I'm just saying, to me, there is something wrong with that. If you're really going to make these points, don't make people like us and other people who have basically took a fiery dump on your response video. The thing is, I know this man isn't even going to freaking respond back or fire back on any of this shit. These probably things were just a bunch of angry fanboys, and we don't deserve to be debated with. That's perfectly fine. I'm used to folks not freaking wanting to debate with anybody because some people think they're so entirely right. They don't want to say why they're right. I mean, they don't want to be challenged. They just want to have their little echo chamber. They want to have their little echo chamber and just keep it like that. But I guess Vox is a group of people. He hasn't seen another dude. Either way, dude. What else you want to talk about? Plain Ray's talking about a freaking Sonic Adventure remake. Man, dude, they might not. All of us are trying to be like, oh, well, they might make a Sonic Adventure remake. They might not. I'm not going to hold my breath and say, oh, maybe that will give us Sonic Adventure 3. Sonic Adventure 3. Ooh. Here's something we can actually enjoy on Sakamaru. Ooh. Turning on the screen, yeah. Ah, Risky, my pirate love. Yeah, I haven't forgotten all those very, very sexual nights. Like Bugsy hasn't forgotten all the nights he had with Shantae. Oh, shit! Shut up, dude! Oh, whatever, Alibaba. Shut up, Aladdin!
Son of a... For once, Death Battle did something right. I told you you got stupid lucky last time.
Shut up! At least I won once!
That's all I ever wanted.
Oh, what the... What did Eggman go? I don't know. That's fucking creepy. What did he fucking do? He just kind of went like he was fucking Shadow Bonnie. Oh my fucking god. What the fuck just happened? I don't know. It's creepy.
I wonder what Mario's doing.
He's probably giving
I think he's looking pretty good.
Oh my god. Oh my god, I gotta say this. God dang, Sonic got fucked up, man. Sonic got fucked up. Jesus. So, Bugsy Boy. What else? Oh, yeah, fucking Mario the Plumber was trying to make fun of Alex Chris. Why? Just because the man's just doing his own thing? Yeah, people hate people talking about fucking leaks because of Dave's videos, but something he wants to do. Y'all can be mad about that all you want, but like he's doing what he wants to do, and when Smash is up, he probably has something else he's gonna do. Ooh, Bugsy, Jackbox Party Pack 5. You thinking what I'm thinking? You thinking we go on Steam and just buy it? Mm-hmm. Scooby-Doo versus Butt. I'm just waiting for them to get to, you know. Oh, you're waiting for them to get to the best Scooby-Doo incarnation. Scooby-Doo Mystery Incorporated, and then we just go back to fucking regular Scooby-Doo shit. Hey, Breezy's back. Oh, good for her. Oh, we got Palace is still here. I don't know where he went. He just came back.
Oh, I can't fucking believe you, Piggy. Well, it's my child. I'm allowed to abandon it. No, that's not cool. We need to go back, and we need to take care of your child. No. Listen. You don't understand, because you're not a father. And if I was a fucking father, then I would take care of my fucking child. Well, somebody has daddy issues. You know what, Pinky? Fuck you. Fuck you, Pinky. God.
Okay, Palace, you got something you want to tell us?
I can't fucking believe you.
I'm glad he's back. Well, I haven't seen a video from him, like, ever. It's been a while. But anyways, guys, we're going to get out of here. Because they're coming. Anyways, guys, we'll see you later. We just want to make a quick video talking about Vox and various other things, because honestly, we would have done more, but Fitz the North Star called Bugsy and he was like, oh, I had something else that was calling me that was a little bit more sweet, you know what I'm saying? But I basically had to go too. I basically was gone too. So me and Bugsy just kind of were gone for like an hour, like a few hours. I was gone for like 8. I was gone for like 6. You know, Bugsy, there's only one person that can pleasure stalking like I can. Like, I get it. It's just me. Well, good for you. Well, guess we'll do another video tomorrow with more time. So we'll see you guys later. Bye, folks. We love you all, and we'll see you later. Bugsy and I have stuff to do. Bye, folks.